If you like alcohol, you're probably intrigued with how it's actually produced. Today we're going to talk about stills. Welcome to Con Man Cocktails. Today we're going to talk about distilling, a little bit more focus on stills, especially if you're in the market shopping for a copper still, or if you're just intrigued with how alcohol is produced. My wife and I have been kind of interested about distilling and just the process of it. We've read books, history, and it's interesting, especially our focus is really on rum and how distilleries are producing rum today, and how they were producing rum yesterday, being years ago. While we're kind of tripping upon this, we came upon a local producer of stills by the name of Stephen Stills. Stephen Stills produces stills for consumers, for businesses, would-be distillers, distillers that are probably making product that you're purchasing today. And the best part is, he lives right down the road. So I was like, hey, let's go visit. And when we got to talking, we came up with this idea of kind of educating people on stills, also educating people on Stephen Stills specifically. So the man behind the copper helped me kind of understand a little bit about stills, plus I took in some education and I learned what makes Stephen Stills different than some of the other stills that exist on the market today. And for those FTC folks or whoever it is that could get you in trouble, Stephen has given us this still to go through this educational process. He's not necessarily sponsoring, but I didn't pay for the still. So you now have that specific information if it makes a difference to you. One last thing, at least if you're in the United States, it is legal to own a still. You can't produce untaxed alcohol with it, but you can have one. The focus here is I'm not gonna show you distillation processes happening, but if you're intrigued by it or if you're in the market for one, for your distilled water or whatever, let's give you some of that basic information. Here are the three components that you're probably going to see in a lot of classic moonshiner stills. This is a pot still. It's not a reflux still, a big calm still. Well, it can be if you install that on the top, which we'll talk about in a minute. This specific still layout would be something that you'd see from classic moonshiners. So this is your main still. This is where all of your mash, your wash, or whatever it is you're producing, in the case of rum, like I use as an example a lot of times, this would be a wash. It's molasses and sugar, basically. It's been fermented. You put it in here, and you bring it to a specific temperature to get that ethanol to actually start to boil and turn into a vapor. That's done through this little machine here, which is something that stands out with Stephen Stills, is that he's kind of custom tweaked and designed a heating system that gets your temperature up the way it needs to be without going crazy and spiking and causing all kinds of problems. A little bit more on that in a bit. So once the vapor reaches the top and it starts to heat up here, it's going to run through this copper pipe, and it's going to keep going through the copper pipe until it falls. This is your thumper. So the thumper is supposedly, it's been named because some of the wash that thumps in here, it also makes a thumping sound. The thumper is like a secondary distilling, which we'll talk about in a minute once I take these pipes down and I can see you better. Once it hits the thumper and it gets back up to temperature, it's going to go through here and through that little copper right here, and the vapor is going to land in the coils. Once it's in the coils, it cools off because you're going to have a nice cold water in here, and there's pipes in the back that you can run water through it through a hose or whatever, and it's going to come out of the bottom in this little spigot. Let's just take some of these pipes down so I can see you better. One of the beauties of Stephen Stills is it comes apart in a lot of different pieces. And why that matters is when you need to clean them, or you need to do any work, or move them, or store them, it comes apart manageably. So a little bit about a still. You get stills of different gauges of copper. The big difference here is this right here is a 20 ounce, 22 gauge copper. It's 99.9% pure Paul Revere copper. Why does that matter? Because the heavy weight of this means that you're gonna have a lot less dings. If you were to use a low gauge copper, you could pretty much tap it and cause it to ding. So if you have a still around for a while and you've got to move it, you've got to do things with it, you've got to use it, you're going to find it's going to start to look like a kind of big pile of mess. And because it's so heavyweight, it can hold a lot more product. This holds 9 pounds of mash per gallon, and it's a 10-gallon still. Believe it or not, when you start to fill these up, they get quite heavy. So having a heavy-duty still means that could be the difference between a still that's producing for you and a still that's producing on you. All your solder points are silver bearing. There's no lead. Lead is bad. One of the big things with moonshiners and producing product by just creating a still in their backyard out of spare parts is you could tend to kill yourself. You shouldn't use things that have had poison or other things that are bad for human consumption. Lead is one of those things. And if you're in the market to buy a still, you want something that's not going to harm you. It comes with all the hoses and copper parts that you need, including all these unions all done in copper. Copper. Everything's copper. And for the worm, it comes with your hose connections. This one happens to have a shark bite connector on it that I put on there myself to be able to play with pumping water. And it looks beautiful. So much so, Carl's Jr. used it in one of their ads. Check this out. Yes, it's a moonshine burger. When it comes to tradition, there's a lot of differences in different styles of stills. You've got your pot still, you have a reflux still or a calm still. This is your traditional pot still, the way it's set up right now. You could, if you wanted to, make this a reflux still. This one has what is known as a cap logic system that Stephen Stills designed, which we'll explain a little bit more in a second. But if you were to take that cap off and put the column on top, you can make yourself more of that reflux still. Pot stills are often used for your moonshines, for your rums, anything where you want the flavor to travel through the distillate. It doesn't fully separate the congeners and esters and all the things that bring flavor. So it's allowing some of that flavor to make it through to the spigot. If you're looking at a column still, when you're making a very clean ethanol, like a vodka or a grain, neutral grain spirit, you're looking for the clean grain, no flavor. Pot stills are going to exhibit some sort of flavor to it. So it's an imperfection if you're going for flavorless. I don't understand flavorless spirits myself. I'm in it for the joy. So a pot still to me makes more sense. And you'll see most rums use a pot still or pot still and a reflux still or calm still and blend those two together. With a reflux still, when you add these columns to the top, or if you ever look at column stills that go straight up, they have little fractioning columns between them. So there's small plates, and in between are these little columns. And what those do is allow the distillate to rise up, struggles to get through to the next column, and often sinks down. Some of it gets through, and then it gets through to the next layer, and the next layer. The more columns you have, the more pure, and the more strength you're gonna have into your spirit. So these pot stills, running it through once isn't going to have the same proof coming out as a column still will. You could keep running it through over and over and continually increase the proof. It just takes more time and cleaning. And that's really because the reflux is scrubbing that vapor as it goes up. So if you want to have, say, a 6x distilled vodka or an 8x distilled vodka, one way you can do it is you could put it through a pot still 8x and call it an 8x distilled product. Or feed this into another pot still 8x. The other way is you can run it through 8 of those plated columns. So you only have to actually produce the product once, and you can have an 8x distilled product. I personally just like lower distilled because there's still some flavor. If you'd like me to make a video a little bit more on comparing and contrasting pot stills versus reflux stills, write your comments below. The pot still is going to bring a lot of flavor and a lot of aroma, and you could get some esters in there that are going to give you like rich bananas and pears and other types of flavors. But if you want to be able to reduce your cost but also bring in the flavor, you can use a column still to produce a batch of rum that's all done in a column. It's going to have a little less flavor, maybe a lot less flavor, depending on how it gets distilled and how many columns there are, and you blend that with your pot still. So this creates a more expensive product, which you then cut with the least expensive product and build a hybrid that meets the flavor that the master distiller is looking for. Stephen Stills stills also come with a DVD if you want some recipes and a place to start if you're now a hobbyist distiller or wannabe hobbyist distiller and don't know where to go. Also, what I've found is the internet is extremely helpful. And as I said, Stephen sells the reflux if you did want to create a reflux or have the option of doing pot and reflux. One of the other key things about Stephen Stills is he uses a plasma cutter to cut all your copper pieces. So you're not going to get yourself cut up and slashed in a bad way with a still like this. It also comes fully assembled with free shipping, so you don't have to deal with getting a still that's flat. My father's done this. He was having fun and he built his own still, but I believe most of it came flat and you had to bend it and put it all together. That is not me. I need something that's already ready to go. That way I'm not gonna hurt myself, it's not gonna look really bad, and it's just gonna function. My favorite toy is the thumper. The thumper is very useful, especially in the cases of rum and things that need to go through a multiple distillation phase or you wanna add flavor. Because all your vapor is gonna fall into the thumper, what you can do is what's known as charging the thumper. You put additional alcohol in here. So if you were to create, say, a molasses wash with molasses and sugar that's been fermented, you put your molasses in here, plus you add like 3/4 to here, And now all that hot vapor comes down and it charges up the alcohol that you added in here, creating a second distillation phase. That means the molasses in here is adding additional flavor and upping the alcohol before it comes out the spigot. If you wanted to produce your own gin, and this is your neutral grain spirit, be it corn or whatever your specific fermented product is, as that travels through here, this could be a mixture of some of this alongside herbs, say like, I don't know, juniper, coriander, cardamom. You throw that in here through the little handy dandy hole that comes right there. Now when your vapors come into here, they're infused with those herbs when they come out in here. So you might have started with a neutral grain spirit, say vodka, or other grain alcohol, and then out of here, you have gin. With Stephen Stills, you can also put them on a propane burner. This has been built so it can sit on a propane platform, and you can use it as a traditional moonshining still. Some people get all up in arms because you're not heating with fire. Other people, what I'd like to call the smarter ones, don't like to play with fire and alcohol together because it can cause more explosive things to occur. So having an electric unit makes a lot more sense. In this case, what we have is a 550 watt pit controller. This controller allows the temperature to rise up intelligently. So if you set this to 205, it will get to about 201 and then step itself up to 205. And the beauty behind that is getting something up to temperature slower is a lot easier to manage than bringing up too high and trying to cool it down. As it turns out, things don't cool down on their own very quickly. One of the other things that stands Steve's products out from the others is the CapLogic system. Now, this is an optional component. You don't have to do it. If you want to save a little bit of money, you can use the traditional means. But this is freaking awesome. So, let's say you have this pot still, and you want to get product in there. How the heck are you going to do it? It needs to go in the top. But if it's going to go in the top, how do you seal it? Because the top is also where the heat comes in. With the CapLogic system, you can unbolt this, take this part off, and then peel back with this nice rubber gasket and this cool little lid. You can take this off, fill your product up, put the lid and the cap back on, and it takes like all of 2 minutes. Otherwise, you need sealing tape and you need to get a good proper seal so that it doesn't leak while it's actually going through the distillation. So if you're in the market for a pot still and you want to kind of get a little bit of a hobbyist thing going on, you want to produce your own stuff completely legally because you're going to follow all the guidelines and rules or whatever, you can check it out. There's links below for Stephen Stills' website. It's actually www.stills.com. I'll put it over here too. And there's a link below if you want to check them out on eBay. And if you do end up picking one up, make sure you tell them you saw it on Con Man Cocktails, because that would be super cool. I'd like to create some more content using the still since it's here. If you guys have any questions or you want a video specifically about how the still works, how more in-depth detail that's focused on the distillation, just let me know. Write it in your comments below when you hit the like on this video. For now, check the two videos out on the sidebar. Click on one of those two. It's going to be really cool. One of them will be a link to Does Moonshine Make You Go Blind? A kind of a follow-up or a prequel to this specific video. We're teaching you how to distill.